2020. It was a special year for everybody, and for me as well. Started nicely, so. With good achievements and good wishes towards new feelings. I finished my lovely Dendria in January, a portrait of a beautiful model I submitted for the show in the Evanston Art Center, and it was sold almost immediately, which was very unusual for this kind of art show. Another piece I was working at the beginning of the year is the Red Button. It's about the concept of the world balance. Thousands of years of human history can disappear in a fraction of a second, and it takes only a fraction of a second to press a button. About at the same time, I welded a nest for my egg, which has a personal meaning for me. In general, an egg is an important symbol representing a beauty and the future and potential. The future is nestling in the present. I was welding nest and smithing torrents at the pumping station 1. It's a great center of creativity in Chicago. In mid-February, I went to Rockford for Illinois Snow Sculpture Competition. One of the team needed a member instead of one who dropped off. I came to help, and it was 2 days of challenging and fun work. The piece was carved out of 10 feet tall and 6 feet wide and 6 feet deep black. And also it was a rare case of collaboration this winter, thanks to the Highland Park Art Center and thanks to Sasha Gashunin, my friend and artist. And Sasha is probably most easy to work with artist I know. Actually, he proved it later in our summer projects. This time, I've made a piece, Fear of the Future. I made it in clay, and Sasha improved it with his specific finish. Later, in June, July, we've been working on 44 inches diameter relief of the lion head. And also ornaments for 5 feet tall Hanukkah menorah. Both pieces were executed at Arctic, and this is a company they specialize on custom design and art projects.
Without model, actually it's also interesting, but the thing is that unfortunately, often when you work without model, you getting disappointed eventually because you find that well, there is a mistake and so on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the work is figure sculpture without model many times is it never again because no, not many. I probably was trying a couple of times.
In July, I've got a call from a family of Paramat Kumar. The family commissioned me to create his bust. Paramat passed away a few years ago, and he was a remarkable man. He was an engineer, and he was a businessman and philanthropist. And it was quite a challenging project, challenging in a few ways. Only a few pictures were available, and I've had only 14, 16 days from start to finish. The family and myself were really happy with the outcome. I work in 3D, so I used only three dimensions, and I created a maquette that I called Orange. I submitted this maquette to San Jose, California. They've been working on a quite great public sculpture in a scale comparable to Eiffel Tower. And I really respect an idea and how it was organized and just very transparent and vibrant. I love clay. I don't know if I was born with this love. But from the time I can remember, I remember myself playing with clay. As a kid, I worked in modeling clay of different colors. 50 books of the encyclopedia were marked with this sticky substance, making my dad angry. I was working on my 2 feet by 2 feet sculpture garden, making landscapes, planting trees, and filling this environment with lots of animals. The encyclopedia had great pictures of existing and extinct species. All that clay jungle was built on a piece of plywood in a corner of the room. Once, my little brother, who was not walking very well back then, awkwardly sat on the top of my garden, destroying everything. Well, I kept this love dormant most of my life, but never lost it entirely. It sort of gives me a connection to the original source. My language in sculpture uses line, shape and texture, and minimum colors. I am fluent in this language. It gives me power to make an observation, to speak to myself, and talk to others. This composition of masses, darkness, and light create a pavement to the essence, or at least show the direction. Clay is a medium that energizes my creativity, channels my thoughts, and I rarely take pen and paper to sketch. For me, it's a clay in my hand. I love clay. Kind of in between things, I sculpted a twisted torso and a column, and I found they look interesting together, and I named them Twist. Then somebody in Hawaii has bought my croc cage through Saatchi Art. And before sending this piece to Hawaii, I made a similar piece, a little bit larger. It wasn't a complete piece. I just made a half in order to prepare a mold and cast some version of this later. I did it at the beginning of this year, and I called Love. And here is a strange primitive head. It's a part of the installation which I called from the beginning. And there are two big arms. They, you can see they're in progress. And it's a larger version, it's 32 inches tall, version of my old composition, Playing with Shadows. Right now they're on display at Fortune Discoveries. It's a very nice gallery in 1022 West Hermitage. That year, 2020, was long and special, filled with events that we didn't see coming. It's kind of strange for me to say it was. Usually transition to the new year leaves a mental mark, feeling of destination in my mind. It doesn't happen this time. I feel I am still sailing, and the shore which is on the map is not seen by my eye yet.